Hello, I want all of you. So welcome to the RUSL Explorer channel once again with another new video. As you can see, I'm in a different location. I'm in the city park in the Panagura city. So today I'm going to take my time to make another video about bird watching. So today we are going to talk about another bird that can be commonly seen in my home garden. So this bird is known as the greater cockle. In local language it is known as Attikukula, and there are some other English words that are used for this bird. So they are the common cockle, the crow peasant, the southern cockle. So we are going to talk about this bird in detail. So before going into further details, let's have a look at this bird. Alright, so I think you saw this bird well, and I'm pretty sure that if you are a Sri Lankan, you are very much familiar with this bird. You may have seen this in your home garden numerous times. So I thought to add more information for your interest. So actually this bird's scientific name is Centropus sinensis. It belongs to order called Cuculiformes, and it belongs to a family called Cuculidae. So under the Cuculidae family there are cuckoos, then roadrunners and anis in it. So if I consider the great cockle, which you can see in this video, this bird is widely spread throughout the Indian subcontinent and the southeast part of the world. So that means Southeast Asia, right? So this bird is like a crow looking one, which has a long tail and a slender body, but it has strong legs. And also it is a bird who is weak in flight. Under this family, Cuculidae, there are nearly 12 species of birds that can be seen in my country. They are the common cuckoo, common hawk cuckoo, Indian cuckoo, then comes the Asian emerald cuckoo, chestnut wing cuckoo, banded bay cuckoo, grey-bellied cuckoo, then fork-tailed drongo cuckoo, then the malkuhas like red-faced malkuha, then blue-faced malkuha, then it is called circular malkuha, and then comes the cockles like greater cockle, the lesser cockle and green-billed cockle. So if you consider these 12 species, only two are endemic to the country. They are the red-faced malkuha, which is known as Wataratu malkuha in Sinhala, and the other one is the green-billed cockle, which is known as the Bata Attikukula. These birds are like, they have copperish brown feathers. I think there are more and more facts that I need to tell you. But beforehand, there's another video I recorded in my home garden. So let's see some more cockle action before going into more and more interesting facts. Let's see another video of this bird. Thank you. I'm sure that you are now very much familiar and aware of this bird called Aticucula in local language or Greater Cockerel in English. Yes, there are some more interesting facts to discuss. So actually this bird is a ground feeder. It feeds on small animals that it can tackle, such as snails, small snakes, eggs, nestlings of birds. Then it can be small lizards and insects as well. And also they are actually solitary hunters, or you can rarely see them in pair going hunting. And also this bird is like, they have two distinct breeding seasons throughout the year. One falls from February to September, and the other one is from October to December. It is said that it lays two to three eggs in a clutch in a dome-shaped nest, which is made in a thorny bush or upper palm tree. What else I need to say about this bird? And also it is said that this bird pairs for the whole life, right? It finds a partner and it is the same partner throughout the whole life. And during foraging, they keep contact with each bird by giving out calls like whoop, 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 right? So if you are Sri Lankan, you may very familiar with this sound. I think I told you all the most important facts about this bird. Yeah, I think there's another video remaining just to watch. So let's go into that video directly. Wait, before going to the video, actually I missed another important point for all of you. This common breeding bird in Sri Lanka can be seen in home gardens, cultivation lands, then scrub lands, and the forest edges of the wet zone, and in the jungles in the dry zone. So now let's go to the video. I think I gave more and more interesting facts and information about this resident bird that can be seen in most of the Sri Lankan home gardens. So I hope you enjoyed the video and learned many things about this bird. So, and also I hope I encourage you to do bird watching if you haven't done. So you can do it while you are traveling anywhere in the world. So it's really interesting to collect these facts, and if you can enlighten the other people as well. So once again, thank you so much for watching from the beginning. If you did so, appreciate a lot. So I will wind up this video from this point. So if you are interested to see this type of videos, including travel videos in my country, Sri Lanka, you know what to do. And also I can help you in turn. So I think that's enough. Thank you once again. And we'll meet next week. I bow on to all of you until then. Bye-bye.